voice this morning. Maybe the medical doctor have concluded you that you can never be fruitful. I have come to announce to you this morning, you shall be fruitful.
Yeah.
I say you shall be fruitful.
Yeah.
In the name of the Lord Jesus Christ, so shall it be in Jesus' name. Our Sunday teaching series is there no bound in Gilead? It is, if you look at that question, that sentence is a question mark at the back of it. Is there no bound in Gilead? Let's open our Bible to Jeremiah chapter 8, verse 20. Jeremiah chapter 8, verse 20. Is there no bound in Gilead? Say, the harvest has passed, the summer has ended, and we are not saved. And in verse 21, say, for the odds of the daughter of my people, he said, I am odd, I am black, and astonishment has taken hold of me. And in verse 22, say, is there no power in Gilead? Is there no physician yet? Then why is the edge of the daughter of my people? Underline that word there, of my people. My people. This is God speaking. So you can be a born again child of God and still find yourself sick. So it is not your spirituality alone that makes you enjoy Sunday. It is your knowledgeability.
Of his health
Praise God. I want to buy that. I want to do this. I want to do that. Your health comes first. Say, I wish you above all peace that thou may prosper and be in health. You will be in health.
Amen.
In the name of the Lord Jesus. So health is your greatest asset. Guide it jealously. You will not lose your health.
Amen.
In the name of the Lord Jesus Christ, you will not lose your health. In the mighty name of the Lord Jesus. So God is not happy you see or sick. He's not happy. That's why he said, I am black. The heart of the daughter of my people I am hot. So when you are sick, God is not happy. You know why? He has made provision already. Because the price has been paid. It's not like you saying you something you have paid for, and somebody ignorantly is also paying. So it means your own payment is waste. You won't be happy. He has paid the price. When Jesus Christ was hung on the tree, and he said, it is finished. It means that pain is finished.
Amen.
The price has been paid already. So God cannot stand you being sick. So many of us will begin to look at God. You have been in this situation all this while. What are you doing? Are you not there? Sir, he's not happy. The provision is there. It's just that you don't recognize it. It's just that you don't recognize it. If you agree with me, not all issues as solution will be drugs. No, not all. But every issue that may come to man, or that many may be thinking as money, as a solution in Christ. It has a solution in Christ. The price has been paid already. That is why Jesus Christ, which is a great physician, is present in Zion. Jesus Christ is here. Praise God. Jesus Christ is here. The greatest physician, the specialist of all, is here. So any form of sickness and diseases is not returning home with you this morning.
Amen.
I said it is not returning home with you this morning.
Amen.
In the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. So you must come to that understanding. Zion is just like a spiritual clinic that you come, all manner of sickness and diseases. But it is a spiritual clinic. Your case can never be referred to any place again. That is the final gospel. Praise God. I've seen situations, God is unbelievable for me. They take somebody to the hospital. After the doctor, they have tried. The doctor will begin to scratch his head. I think you need to, how did they say it in our language? So you need to put our local leg into it. Praise God. They tried all manner. They couldn't see that. I think, see, Jesus Christ is the bus stop for every form of sickness and diseases. And Jesus is here this morning. So that's your disease and that's your sickness is coming to an end this morning.
Amen.
It's coming to an end this morning.
Amen.
It's coming to an end this morning.
Amen.
In the name of the Lord Jesus.
Amen.
Jesus is the ultimate solution to every issue concerning our health. He's the greatest physician. He's the ultimate solution. Nowhere you can go out of it. So we must have that understanding that the price has been paid. It is not even in a drug. Let's open our Bible to Jeremiah chapter 42, 46 verse 11. Jeremiah 46 verse 11. Look at what the Bible said here. Jeremiah 46 verse 11. Let's open up and see. He says, go up into where? To Gilead. And do what? And take back. In vain shall thou use many words. Medicines to no help us. Jeremiah 46 verse 11. Thou shalt go up to Gilead and take the band. The word of God is the band of God. And the word of God is resident in Zion. Thou shalt go up to Gilead and take band, all you children of the greater. He said, in vain thou shalt take many medicines, for thou shalt not be what? Oh, you can see there. It is not in the numbers or in the beauty of the drug you swallow. No! That's why I said, your health is not in the doctor. Your health is not in the drug. Your health is secured in him. Said, thou shalt go to Gilead. And to do what? To do what? To take balm. That's why I said, is there no balm? Is there no physician there? Thou shalt take balm in Gilead. Praise God. And in verse 5, let's continue verse 5. Therefore, he was wounded for what? Verse 5. Verse 11. Go up to Gilead and take balm. In vain, thou shalt not take many medicine and not be cured. So, thank God for the medicine we take. Well, Jesus is the main medicine. Jesus, which is the word of God, if you don't know, is the main medicine you and I need. It is the main medicine you and I need to secure our rights in total health. And that shall be the name of Jesus. In Luke chapter 5, verse 17, Jesus Christ, the main medicine we need. He was preaching on a Saturday, and many people gathered to hear him. And as he was preaching the word, the Bible makes us understand, he said, the power of God was present to do what? To heal them all. The power of God was present to heal them all. If you go back to verse 15, you discover the people actually came to hear him, verse 15, and to be healed. Praise God. There was so much that they went there, a fame upon of him, and great multitude. Look at what he said. Great multitude gathered to do what? To hear, and to what? And to be healed. So there is a direct link of hearing the word and your healing. You didn't get it. There is a direct link between hearing the word and your healing. They gather a link between hearing the word and your healing. They gather to hear it, and as they hear the word, they will heal. Even as you are hearing the word right now, you are healed. I say you are healed. Lord Jesus, as I'm speaking the word of God right now, something that is not part of your body is leaving your body right now. I said something that happened to be a stranger in your body is leaving your body right now. In the name of Jesus, in Psalm 18, verse 47, he said, his angels shall fade away out of their eating or hiding places. Every stranger. Sickness is a stranger in your body. Headache is a stranger in your body. So, no matter how beautiful or handsome you are, so when the headache and the one, you look at that. So, it is a stranger. Hearing barrenness is a stranger in your body. And what is the Bible speaking? In Psalm 18, verse 45. Let's look at it. Psalm 18, should you help us? Psalm 18 verse 45. He said, the strangers shall fade away and be afraid out of their close places. Every stranger in your body, is going out. Every stranger of Adeyi, of pain, of leg pain, of stomach pain, of barrenness in your body is leaving you right now. In the name of the Lord Jesus. But the truth is this, we must understand our right to totality. We must understand our right to totality. By redemption, we share eternal life with God, which is immune to all sickness and diseases. Remember in the popular scripture of John 3:16, say, for God so loved the world. For God so loved the world, and you know what? He gave his own son, that whosoever believe on him shall not do what? Shall not die. Whosoever believe on him shall not die, but do what? But share an eternal life with God. So by redemption, we share eternal life with God. So you must come to that understanding. Also, by the Holy Ghost that dwells in us, we are spiritually positioned to enjoy divine health. Romans chapter 8, verse 11. He said, for if the Spirit that raised Jesus Christ up dwells in you, he said, he that raised up Christ from the dead shall do what? Shall quicken in your mortal bodies. He shall quicken in your mortal body. So if the Spirit of God, which is the Holy Ghost, that raised Christ up from the dead, he can quicken in your mortal body. So that day we leave you in the name of the Lord Jesus. So shall it be in the mighty name of Jesus. But what is it in the name of Jesus Christ that is? What is that thing that is in the name of Jesus Christ that is? The first thing, the name is full of wonders, including the healing wonders. You check Isaiah chapter 9, verse 6. He said, for unto us a child is born, unto us a son is given. He said, the government shall be upon the shoulder, and his name shall be called what? Wonderful. It means his name is full of wonders. The name of Jesus Christ is full. Sir, no prayer you pray without the name of Jesus that receives speedy answer. Say, no one come to me. No one come to the Father except what? To me. In the name of Jesus Christ lies the wonders, including the wonders of healing. I've seen someone have come, hey, I have this habit. In the name of the Lord Jesus, be healed, and that is over. In the name, because in his name contains the healing wonders. In the name of the Lord Jesus. Not when we begin to call his name, we don't know the value of the name. There is power in the name of Jesus Christ. The power that can terminate any form of sickness and disease, no matter how long it is. In the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. Praise God. In the name of Jesus, he carries the irrevocable gifts of God, which empowers him to heal at will. Say, he has exalted and he gave him a name that is far above every other name. He said, the gift of God are without repentance. He has given the power that with your name, every knee must bow and every tongue of sickness or disease must confess at the sound of the name of the Lord Jesus. And at the mention of the name of the Lord Jesus, every sickness in your life is bowing down today. It's bowing down today. In the name of the Lord Jesus, so shall it be in Jesus' mighty name. When we anoint the sick with anointing oil in the name of the Lord Jesus, they are healed. When we anoint in the name of the Lord Jesus, in his name contain the anointing of healing. In his name contain the anointing of healing. When you mention the name, the anointing flows down and destroy every form of body and yoke of sickness in your life in the name of the Lord Jesus. But to sustain our health, what must I do? What must I do to sustain? We must remain committed to serving God. We must remain committed to serving God. Let's open our Bible to John chapter 15, verse 1 and 2. Where it says, I am the true vine. My Father is the husbandman. And in verse 2, say, every branch in me that beareth not fruit, he cut away. Every branch in me that beareth not fruit, he cut away. And every branch that bear fruit, he purges it. To do what? To bring more fruit. So if you are a Christian and you are not a fruit-bearing Christian, sir, you are at risk. If you are a Christian, a winner for that matter, and we are in our operation, take your territory for Christ, and not even one soul being accounted to you, sir, is a risk. Look at it. For example, I think I've shared a testimony of this before. I've once been in a station where within the compound we have a big mango tree. It produces very well. We have another, they call it this Dogoyaro tree, also in the north. I think we have three trees. So the elders of the church, they came and said they want to cut tree. They want to cut the mango tree that is obstructed. And I look at them. This mango tree. But when I came into that session, I met the fruits of that tree. So sweet, big with tiny seed in it. I said, no, this one you will cut. In short, they have even marked the body, build the something around, and that is the position to cut it. I said, just leave this one. Look for it, a new tree, look for another tree. Why? Because that mango tree is what? Fruitful. Because that mango tree is fruitful. In the same way, in the spirit of the land, in the realm of the spirit. See, when you are fruitful, when we call out outreach, you are there for it. When we call this, you are making sure you are out there bringing fruit and making your fruit abide. It says, any branch that beareth fruit, he purchases it, he takes care of it, he secures it for it to bring much fruit. So if you are on the go for Christ and you are a fruitful Christian, you are not permitted to begin to spend your money on sickness. If you are fruitful, say a branch in me that beareth fruit, he purchases. But the one that doesn't bear fruit, he do what? He cut it away. You shall never be cut away. What a great opportunity. We are just 2 weeks more to go. Operation, take your territory for Christ. Come October 7, 2018. It will be a reality. In the name of the Lord Jesus. And you and I will make it work. By now, the first service should even be running to the flow. If we are going to be tripling our attendance of October 7, 2018, 2017, then we still have a long way to go. But I believe as the Lord lives, it will come to pass. I said it will come to pass. Some people are even afraid to say amen. Because you are not ready to do it. Praise God. So that is our primary assignment. Thank God for the preaching. Thank God for church to guide us. But that is the mandate that God has given to you and I. The ministry of what? Of reconciliation. Praise God. The ministry of reconciliation. You are an ambassador of heaven, representing the interests of heaven by bringing many into Christ. And the Bible speaking in Proverbs chapter 13. Verse 17. He said, and a faithful ambassador is what? Enjoys health. A faithful ambassador enjoys health. As you are on the go, representing the say Cotonou. Praise God. Hallelujah. Praise God. Now, it does not matter how worse is the condition of Cotonou. I will enjoy the same rate or the same facility that is entitled to me in Nigeria. Okay, let me take this, you don't understand that. Okay, an ambassador of US to Nigeria, and the ambassador, one way or the other, fell sick. Will they carry him to one mushroom clinic in Ibuta here? No. No! No! They can't carry him to one mushroom hospital in Ibuta. They have to carry him to the best, impossible, of his mother home. If you are an ambassador of heaven, and if sickness can never be found in heaven, if pain can never be found in heaven, then it is an alien in your body. It must go.
Amen.
It must go. You can see the picture. So if you are a faithful and fruitful ambassador, you enjoy it. You enjoy else. And how do you do that? These 2 weeks must not go. I must have at least 2 so. Each week. Thank God we said 12. If we can't meet up in 12. So, there is nothing impossible for God. A day alone, God can give you 1 and 12. If your heart is in it, if your heart is in it, God can give you more than 12 in a day. And that should be your testimony. In the name of the Lord Jesus. So serving God and the interest of his kingdom delivers you from barrenness. It delivers you from barrenness. From Exodus chapter 23, verse 25 to 26. He said, if you take sickness away from the midst of them, say the numbers of their days, he said, if we fulfill. And in verse 26, he said, no shall be what? Serving God. No shall be barren in the midst of. So it is an error for you to be serving God and remember it. Every trace of barrenness, either body barrenness, academic barrenness, financial barrenness, I come and I destroy it in the name of the Lord Jesus.
Be born.
the first step. Lord, children are the heritage of the Lord. It is his property, and only his child are entitled to his property. Praise God. Lord, children, in Psalm 127, verse 3, say, Lord, children are the heritage of the Lord. They are God's property. Remember, it says, every good gift and perfect gift in James 1:17, say, it comes from the Lord. So you must have that understanding. If it's God's property, and if I become a child of God, I am entitled to God's property. If I am a child of God, I am entitled to his property. So you must be born again. Number two, believe God for your fruitfulness. Luke chapter verse 45 says, blessed is she that what? That believeth. That shall be what? A performance. Blessed. You don't need to believe all the medical reports and everything they have said concerning you. Sir, they can say it is not in their opinion. People may have opinion about you. They may have suggestion about you. They may even have conclusion about you. But whose report will you believe? Whose report will you believe? Because you have a mandate of fruitfulness upon you. He said, be fruitful. So it has nothing to do with the suggestion of men. Your fruitfulness has nothing to do with the opinion of men or even options of men. It is a commandment that you must be. Indeed, you shall be fruitful. In the name of the Lord Jesus. Number three, be filled with the Holy Ghost. Be filled with the Holy Ghost. Be filled with the Holy Ghost. Number four, enter into a covenant to keep serving God and the interest of the kingdom with joy. With joy. Say, with joy shall you what? Draw water out of the well of salvation. If you are serving God as if they are forcing you to serve him, there will be issues. Because the reward will not come. It won't come. Because God checks your heart. Your heart, not your action. Praise God. He checks your heart, not your action. Your motive of doing what you are doing. Are you doing it joyfully? Acceptably? Praise God. Number five. Continue to give glory to God for your fruitfulness. You also in that picture, Romans chapter 4, verse 20. The Bible says, Abraham staggered not at the promise of God through unbelief. He was strong in faith. How? Giving glory to God. Giving glory to God. No matter what, no matter circumstances you find yourself, sir, must give glory to God. Give glory to God. That is the secret. That is the secret. Finally, Psalm 67, verse 6 and 7. Psalm 67 from verse 3 now. Say, let the people praise thee, O Lord. Let the people praise thee. And in verse 6, it says, then the earth shall do what? Shall yield and increase. So, if the people will not praise him, if the people will not praise him, then the earth shall not yield and increase. You can see it. The earth shall yield and increase. We set to praise God this morning. We set to praise God this morning. We set to praise God this morning. Please, let's be on our feet with a shout to the Lord. Let's be on our feet with a shout to the Lord. In the set to praise God. And as you praise him, you shall be fruitful indeed in the mighty name of Jesus. Praise God. But please, before we go ahead praising him, he said, I know my sheep. They hear my voice. And they do what? They follow me. So, it's just like this. I know my sheep. They hear my voice, and I hear their voice. That is what it means. So if you are not his sheep, if he's not your shepherd, even as he prays, sing, dance, he's not seeing you. Praise God. All else found eyes closed. You are in the house this morning. You want your praise to be accepted. Therefore, you to be fruitful. You are not saying that you praising God is connected to your fruitfulness. Then you need to surrender your life to Jesus Christ this morning. All else found eyes closed. If you're in that category, you want in every area of your life that fruitfulness must answer. You labor, labor. You work, work. Nothing to show for it. It must stop in your life today. Then you must return to him for him to restore you. Please, if you are there, just raise up your hand. Let me pray with you as we enter our prayer session. You are there this morning. You want all your stuff to restore you. No more labor in vain in your life. Father, we give you all the glory. Blessed be your holy name. Thank you, Mary God, for in Jesus' mighty name we are praying. Please, sir, place your right hand. Look at me, my friend. Let's do that, this, sir. Hallelujah. Say this prayer with me. Lord Jesus, I have come to you this morning. I have tried my best, but I cannot do this thing alone. That's why I have come to you. Lord Jesus, your precious blood shed in the cross of Calvary, let it cleanse me from my sin. Write my name in the book of life, and let me make heaven. And every form of struggles in my life come to an end today. Thank you, Lord Jesus, for saving me. In Jesus' mighty name, you are blessed. The grace that brought you out, the same grace we uphold you in the name of the Lord Jesus. And any area of your life that you have been suffering barrenness, today, because you have returned, fruitfulness begin to answer to you. Fruitfulness answer to the work of your hand. Fruitfulness answer to the fruit of your body. In the name of the Lord Jesus, you are blessed. In Jesus' mighty name. God bless you. See that brother there. It's your friend who are meeting. We want to collect your phone number and your prayer request. So please tell me.